我想呢，外交小尖兵哈，在这个高中这个阶段来推动哈，我特别感谢外交部跟教育部哈，因为这个对于我们高中生的学生来讲的话，是一个很大的挑战。那尤其呢，他们未来可以说是地球村的公民。那如果呢，每一个孩子都能够注意到这些，比如说我们现在教育部所推动、外交部所推动的呢，它的议题哈，都是社会关心的议题，或者是国际关心的议题。那学生在这个过程里面，在老师的指导之下，每一个人呢都能够去深入的了解，同时把它表达出来。我觉得这样子的一个历程呢，其实是一个很棒的一个学习。那当然呢，我们在这个整个的一个过程里面，我们看到了学生因为这样的一个活动，然后相互各校之间相互的观摩学习而成长。那当然，我觉得这个学习里面呢，有很多哈，是包括了他的胆识的训练、系统的思考、团队合作的精神。那这些呢，对于他在未来呢，面对世界上的一个各种挑战的时候，他应该都是一个很棒的一个素养跟能力的提升。所以这是我最大的一个心得感想。参赛的同学其实都是各校最棒的，大家都认为选他们出来可以代表学校争取最高的荣誉。那当然，我想我要跟同学讲哈，每一个比赛呢，一定都有输赢。那人生呢，其实就是在这种成功失败当中，整个的一个交替堆叠当中呢，然后慢慢的你历练了，获得了一个很棒的智慧，然后获得了成长，这个我觉得才是最重要的哈。那所以呢，成功固然很开心，那但是呢，失败呢，你也可以如果能够从中获得了一些启示跟醒思的话，我相信一样是成功的意义。在这里呢，祝福每一个同学，谢谢。
评审老师还有各位家长、各位老师、各位同学，大家早安，大家好，再大声一点好吗？大家早安，大家好，好，我叫李宪章哦，现在是外交部公众外交协调会的执行长兼外交部的发言人，所以如果你们以后在电视上看到我，那个很像我的大概就是我了哦。不过上电视通常上新闻不是好事情哦，都是不好的事情才会上电视上新闻，所以以后尽量还是避免这种情况出现哦。那今天很高兴代表外交部来这边跟各位见面，然后也恭喜大家，也欢迎大家今天来参加这样的活动哦。因为我跟外交小尖兵的渊源非常的深厚，我2008年在到2014年6年7个月在伦敦的时候，我接待过2次的小尖兵哦。今年2月份我带了小尖兵去年优胜队伍前三名，我很有这个荣幸跟。运气非常好，我就陪着他们到纽西兰跟印尼去参访哦。这是今年2月的时候，那么很快的马上又到11位，现在就是初赛，12月又要决赛了。那么过去4年，这是我第4次参加中区的分区比赛哦。我回来3年2个月，但是已经参加4次了。那今年12月，当然过去3届我都到公司摄影棚去参加决赛哦，所以我可以感受到。老师跟同学还有家长对这个活动的支持跟这个热情的参与，当然我也可以感受到同学对这个活动的重视还有紧张的程度哦。因为我刚刚从校门走进来的时候，已经看到好几个团队在外面排演哦。那我觉得这样的活动办到今年，我们今年的报名队伍比过去2-3年都还要多，今年有122支队伍参加，特别是我们台中中区的部分哦，有39支队伍。那么比去年跟基本上比2-3年前都还要多哦，所以我在这里代表我们外交部，当然还有我们教育部主办单位，谢谢各位老师、家长还有校长、学校、校方的支持哦。那我今天也要特别感谢我们今天新民高中在提供这么好的场地哦。那去年我们也在这里比赛，所以我觉得回到这里非常的熟悉，我也有我以前的同学在这里担任英文老师哦，所以我觉得非常的荣幸回到这里。以前我在台中念书，所以能够回到台中来是我一直都很期待的事情，所以我想说明年我不见得在台湾，也许外放哦，所以我必须要把握也许是我在台湾的最后一次机会来参加这样的活动，然后跟大家见面，算是鼓励大家，然后也互相期许哦，希望大家能够今天把握这个机会，这个舞台展现自我，不要紧张好不好。其实我站在台上我可以感受到你们的紧张程度，但是我比你们更紧张，为什么呢？ 你们待会儿在台上是四位同学，我在台上只有一个人，我是孤零零的，所以你们等一下只要平常心，发挥自己平常排练的这个成果哦，具体的展现自己哦，不要紧张，好不好？就是跟自己比赛，跟自己竞赛。那么如果说表现优异，那当然我们非常期待我们在这个12月6号公视摄影棚里面我们再见面哦。那我在这边再次谢谢大家，也祝福大家今天都有非常好的表现。然后呢，我们当然外交部跟这个教育部过去几年我们一直在精进这个计划哦，希望增加一些鼓励的一个元素。那除了有参赛证明、参赛证书之外，我们还有增加很多表现优异团队的一些奖项哦。也许金额不是那么多，是一个象征性的鼓励哦，但是我们就希望说在政府非常有限的资源之下，能够鼓励大家能够接触国际事务，然后透过英文竞赛这样的一个平台啊，能够展现自我，然后发挥自我。然后将来如果你们上了大学，我们外交部还有一些计划，像是国际青年大使，毕业之后呢，18岁到35岁之间还可以参加我们外交部有目前有15个国家的青年度假打工哦，每年有像澳洲2名额没有名额限制，英国1000-2000个名额，很多国家，欧洲国家有10个国家哦，所以这些都是大家可以到将来继续跟国际接轨的一个很好的一个媒介跟平台，所以我鼓励大家，今天是一个起点，不是终点哦，所以大家希望能够利用这个机会好好的尽情的展现自己，然后我在这里特别再祝福大家，也预祝大家今天有一个很好的表现，有一个快乐的周末，谢谢大家。
第一对表演的题目是 New Vietnam Style， 计时开始。
Alice is a Viennese woman from a poor family. To reverse her financial predicament, she intends to go to Taiwan and find a job there. However, it was said that Taiwanese people are not very friendly to foreign labors, so she was in hesitation. Suddenly, Alice remembered her homegirl, Jenny,who moved to Taiwan after marriage a couple of years ago. So she made her a call to ask for some advice.
Well, Jenny answered my phone. Hi, Jenny. This is Alice. It's been a long time since we last met. Do you still remember me?
Hi, this is Lisa, Jenny's assistant. Jenny's filming right now. I'm afraid that she can't answer the phone now.
Filming? Didn't she work as housemaid in Taiwan?
You mustn't have connected with her for a long time. She's not only a teacher, but a director of some note now.
A director? Are you sure we are talking about the same Jenny?
Of course.
Lisa, where are you?
I'm coming. Excuse me, I have to go help.Would you like to leave your contact information? I will tell Jenny to respond to you at her convenience.
Okay, thank you so much.
Excellent! And cut!
Wait a minute, Jenny. I think her emotions are not in place. She should have expressed the grief and helplessness of a foreign bride. And...
Hey, Ken, don't be so harsh on her. She has just joined us and she's not a professional actress.
All right, I may be a little too strict. But I just want our work to be truer to real life so that we can away people's awareness about difficulties of foreign bride.
Sounds like you are a foreign bride. But I'm worried that our money can afford us to complete the whole movie. After all, this is our first time trying to make a long documentary film.
Don't worry about it.Your recent few works have gotten favorable comments, and the last one even won an award. What's more, the Taiwanese government now is promoting a new southbound policy. They will subsidize related industries. I think we could get some funds from the authority.
Winning an award is secondary to my end of improving the lives of my fellow sisters. They will suffer at home, and I don't want them to be treated unequally here. Besides that,
Hey, you've done enough. In addition to making the story into movies, you spend every weekend teaching their children Vietnamese in the community, hoping that they will not forget their roots.
It's not a big deal. I had some bad experiences on my own. Had I not met you, I might not have escaped from my miserable life. I've seen Taiwan as my second home, and I hope my family can all be treated equally here.
They will. See, that's how actress can express her sorrow and resentment. It's the evidence that her life is improving to some degree.
Hey, Jenny, what's wrong? You have got a call from your homegirl, Alice. Would you like to call her back?
Alice? I've not heard from her for quite a while. Hope everything is fine with her. Hey, Alice. It's been a long time. Is everything all right?
Not so good. My family can't afford me to continue my education. I'd like to go to Taiwan and find a job there to relieve the burden of my family. Can you help me with that?
Of course. Didn't you major in Chinese in college? It will help a lot finding a job here. Besides, Taiwanese government now is promoting a new southbound policy. They are looking for an overall cooperation with Southeast Asian countries on the aspects of medication, education, technology, agriculture, and so on. And they desperately need some talented people who can be the bridge between the two sides. I believe you can have good development here.
But I heard that townspeople are not friendly to us. I'm afraid of being bullied, and if in trouble, I even have no one to ask for help.
Don't worry about it. Things are much better than you've imagined. Besides, you have me here. Oh, by the way, I still need a teaching assistant who can speak both Chinese and Vietnamese. Why don't you come to help me first, and I'll see if there are any other working opportunities for you.
Really? You're serious? Wow, that will be great.
Let me know when you will come.
Okay, thank you so much. You are really my savior.
Hope to see you soon. Bye.
Bye.
第二队表演的题目是 Fighting for the Future， 计时开始。
Let's call it a day, students. Next time, we will divide class into groups to discuss the subsidy provided by government to foreigners. Please surf the net and collect the information.So that you can discuss it together next time. Class dismissed.
Hey, come here and check this out.
What's going on? Whoa, you act so fast. New southbound policy? Do you know what it is?
I don't know. Maybe my parents will know. I will tell you tomorrow after going home and asking them.
Oh yes, haha.
You could be considered a foreigner.
Yeah, since my father has to work here.I moved with my parents from Vietnam to Taiwan when I was 6. I would like to go back to Vietnam to learn their native language. I will surf the internet to find more information.
Wow, interesting.
Please remember to ask your parents.
I'm home.
Hey.
How's everything in school?
Great. Big brother, I want to ask you a question.
Sure. What is it?
Today, one of my classmates saw an article on the net about the new southbound policy of the government. It read, if the mother is a new resident from a foreign country, the government will subsidize plane ticket cost. Then we can go back to our mother's country to learn the native language.
Yeah, because of the government's new southbound policy.We can have freedom to go back. We also can practice the enemies we are not familiar with.
The goal of tracing back family origins is in the hope that children in their resident family can not only enhance their international workplace knowledge and skills, but also increase their employment competitiveness. This is a new opportunity to establish the educational development.
Really? Then I can take a trip back to Vietnam after graduation. I can even work there.
Yes, then you can either work in Taiwan or Vietnam. This is the government's new southbound policy.
Wow, fantastic! Then I must go back to Vietnam after graduation. I can have more employment opportunity. I will be a new vanguard of the new southbound policy. I think working in Vietnam this month has been very fruitful. I've gotten to know more deeply about the local culture and make friends with the locals. I feel great.
We also eat the most delicious food here.
We should take some pictures here and share them with our classmates after going back home.
Sounds great. Let's go.
Where did you go during your summer vacation?
I went to Canteen. The weather there was marvelous.
I spent most of my time in a library. I hiked in a mountain or swam during holidays.
I went back to Vietnam. I worked and practiced Vietnamese at the same time. At present, if college students work in Vietnam, the salary starts about 35,000 with no internship experience.
Cool, sounds tempting.
What kind of work do you want to engage in the future?
I would like to be a tour guide to introduce cultural attraction in different countries.
I would like to be an animator to draw animation of different national cultures. How about you?
I would like to engage in my undergraduate interior design. I can integrate the design of the different nations' cultural themes.
I believe we can enrich our professional ability as far as the expansion of our life experience.
Yeah, we are still young, so we should make good use of our variable time.
I heard that many young people are in favor of the government's southbound policy. We can no longer rely on China all the time.
I believe that as long as we expand more contacts with Southeast Asian countries, we can make our economy better.
If I have the opportunity, I have to go to Vietnam in the future. It must be very exciting.
That's for sure. Let's go together.
I want to join you too. Mark, can you go with us and be our tour guide?
No problem. I'm sure you will have an unforgettable memory of my company.
Attention, Bob.
Thank you.
第三队表演的题目是 A Journey to the South. 计时开始。
Economic collaboration, talent exchange,
and resource sharing.
Wow, bro, you are so smart.
Thank you.
But do you know how we implement this target?
My pupils, now we all know the importance of our trip. First, economic collaboration. We can export quality, affordable products, as well as introduce new services to these Southeast countries.
Okay.
Second, talent exchange.
That's us. We're a talent. I can work with the ASEAN.
Yes, ASEAN, Association of Southeast Asian Nations. Hey, young professionals like us can share ideas, thoughts, and information.
Hey, I know what you're thinking. It's not a dating website, you pig.
Okay.
Very well, my pupils. Third, resource sharing. We can share our ideas and skills, the so-called soft power.
Master, that means we can establish bilateral cooperation.
Yes, let's go to the south.
Let's go.
Hey, wait for me!
Look! Hey, they love our facial mask product. Their sales have boosted over the past few months.
Of course, we use Taiwan's breakthrough technique to add in anti-cancer nanocapsules with the magical effect of preventing overall cancer. How can Indians resist it?
Oh no!
Okay, what happened?
The Indian government wanted to stop selling their products right away.
Why is it?
They say we didn't go through all the legal procedures.
But we have tried. It's so hard. Now we are finished.
Wait. This is a song.
Master, we only have less than 2 minutes. What song?
Don't you remember that the emperor told us if we have any problems, we could turn to India Center.
What is it?
All right. It's an institute established by Taiwan External Trade Development Council.
Yes, exactly.
Master!
是 Taiwan makes you feel at home. 计时开始。
Now is the time for the award ceremony. Women singles gold medalist Lisa Kuing from Thailand.
Congratulations! I'm so proud of you. You're the pride of Thailand.
Thank you. I couldn't make it without your support. Hey, you didn't forget our deal, did you?
You made a short trip to Taichung after winning the gold medal? Of course not. Let's go.
My best friend, Jessica, she is an exchange student to Taiwan to study Chinese. if anyone can recommend other tourist attractions.
We would be glad to be your tour guide if you don't mind.
Thanks a lot. We can't wait to see more of this beautiful city.
Great. Let's take the iBike and show them our city.
A new generation, a new southbound vision. 计时开始。
ASEAN is also selected as the fourth biggest
ACM Magnifier, a roundtable discussion on the new South Bond policy. 计时开始。
Welcome to ACM Magnifier. My name is Maggie Wong. Taiwan's government has announced plans for the new South Bond policy to make the relationship between our country and 18 nations located in South Asia and Oceania stronger. Tonight, we will focus on three countries.Who are working closely with Taiwan in the fields of tourism, trade, and education. First off, from Thailand, we have Lin Mao Lu, the CEO of Thai Jili Tours. Lin will offer some ideas for our tourism industry here in Taiwan. Welcome, Lin.
Sawadika. It's nice to be here.
Next is JJ Fun, the first CEO of Mikey Sports Shoes, who owns a factory outside Hanoi in Vietnam.JJ has been working closely with Aboriginal groups in Taiwan to help create a top-selling sports shoe. Hello, JJ.
Good evening, Maggie. It's a pleasure to be here.
And finally, rounding out our guest is Teresa Lau, a public policy and global affairs professor from Nanyang Technological University in Singapore. Hi, Teresa.
Hi, Maggie. Thanks for having me.
Lin, the number of tourists who visited Thailand last year totaled more than 32 million, whereas Taiwan drew nearly 11 million. What is happening in Thailand that helps you draw so many people?
Wow, Maggie, let's take a look. Thailand has a government, private sector, people plan, which is the integration of government, business, and residents to create a friendly environment for tourism. Training is provided.So that residents can serve as local guides. I feel Taiwan can work harder in this area. Also, due to their visa-free status, the number of Thai tourists coming to Taiwan is increasing. So I also suggest the government formulate policy to nurture local talent and promote sightseeing.
For Taiwanese in the travel industry, this is well worth studying. Thanks so much for sharing, Lin.Now, let's move on to JJ. JJ, what special news do you want to share?
Well, Maggie, at my Mikey Shoe Factory, we have established cooperation with Taiwan's Hakka culture to release a new type of shoe made by the printed cloth they created.
Wow!
In the past, nobody ever noticed Hakka printed cloth of this quality.But after working together, we have sold over 10,000 pairs of shoes this year.
Wow, that's great.
Yeah, it is the most popular sports shoe right now. My daughter queued all day to buy her.
That's amazing. Any other thoughts from Vietnam?
Well, in the future, we hope to establish innovative cooperation with other aspects of Taiwanese culture.Such as a new design style for some of their Aboriginal totems.
Oh, very nice.
Of course, we will still require the skills of talented foreigners to assist us.
Well, that all sounds so promising. Thank you, JJ. Let's finish up with you, Teresa. Please explain how education in Singapore can benefit the Taiwanese in relationship to the new South Bond policy.
Well, Maggie,When it comes to education, the project we implement may act as a good example. Students as young as junior high age are able to enroll in four types of courses designed to assist them in choosing a career. These include facility maintenance, machinery maintenance, retail sales, and hospitality services.After touring many educational institutes in Taiwan, I believe that this model could prove useful. If this idea can be tested here, it may offer your student better future opportunities.
My! You begin your skill courses at such an early age! What a fine idea!
Yes! Sounds like a great system to get young teens involved when their minds are still open to suggestion.
Well, that's about all our time.I want to thank Teresa from Singapore, Lin from Thailand, and JJ from Vietnam for their thoughts on
culture exchanges between all four countries can flourish and improve cooperation.
Yes, strong communication between our nations in the fields of tourism, trade, and education will improve greatly as we head on to the year 2020 and beyond.
Thanks for tuning to Asia Magnifier. Thank you.
第七队表演的题目是 Click, 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 计时开始。
Let's rock!
benefits of the policy. Maybe I can take a look at my future.
Hey, Jessica!
Hey!
Hey,
what are you doing here?
We're discussing where to have lunch.
I have seen you guys' future 20 years later.
What?
Our
future?
A very remote I haven't seen my future yet.
Oh, come on.
Let's stop dreaming.
Whether I can see my future or not, I believe with the new southbound policy, my future will never be a fantasy. Wait for me.
The 第八队表演的题目是 Cooking Up a Friendship. 计时开始。
Hello, everyone.
Welcome to day 3 of 3rd annual cooking championship. Today is the last day, but before we begin, let's look back on the last 2 days of this exciting competition. On the first day, the theme was a national dish with local ingredients. After the tasting, the judges awarded Team Philippine first place.
Oh yes, lechon is the most popular dish in the Philippines. It has extreme flavors. Today, I went with a sweet and sour glaze and salted pork, and I'm glad that the judges like it.
In a very close second, Team Taiwan wowed the judges.
Today, I prepared steamed pork dumplings. Although simple, its flavor can be very complex. I'm glad the judges enjoy it.
And Team Thailand finished in third. I can't believe it. Third, the golden chicken curry is perfect. I don't know what the judges are thinking. Some salty talk from Thailand. Clearly, he's not happy with the results. Then, on day 2, the competition had a sweet turn as the chefs made desserts. And let's take a look at the video. The rules clearly state that anything that touches the floor can no longer be used. And Team Philippine has a very embarrassing mistake here, losing her eggs. Luckily, Team Taiwan decided to share her eggs with her. Oh, what a touching moment! Making the day 2 results. In the first place, Team Thailand.
Haha! I know I will win with my moon shrimp patties. I could be a champion!
In the second place, Team Philippines.
Oh, I'm so glad that Taiwan helped me. The fried bananas turned out beautifully, and I'm grateful for her help.
In the third place, Team Taiwan.
Well, I plan to make mooncake with egg yolk inside, but without enough eggs, I changed to mango-shaped ice. Although simple, it tastes like summer to me. I didn't win, but I'm happy I made a new friend.
Now, let's get the exciting finale underway and welcome our contestant from Thailand, Chef Brendan, from Philippines, Chef Carol, and from Taiwan, Chef Jenny. For the final competition, we test the competitors to wow us with a soup. Some say soup is simple, but to wow the judges with a soup is a big challenge. Not only that, but the contestants need to make enough soup for everyone in the audience. And let's take a look at their kitchen. Oh, Chef Brendan, what are you making? It looks delicious.
I'm making the hot and sour crystal noodle soup. The secret to my soup is that it is made up of many special spices added all together. It isn't easy to make, but I'm sure I will win.
And let's check in with Chef Carol.
Oh, I'm so proud to represent my country. Today, I'm making sinigang. It's made with pork, shrimp, vegetables, and my secret ingredients.
And let's see Chef Jenny's kitchen.
I'm really excited about the last day. I think it will be my time to shine. I wish I could share a bowl of pork blood soup with everyone in Taiwan.
Ouch! Oh my! Chef Brendan's hurt! Quick, call a doctor! Chef Brendan, are you alright?
It's hurt. I won't live before the end of the contest.
We can help you. What should we do next?
is running out. Chefs have just a few minutes to finish their dishes.
Please.
That's time. Can the chefs please present their final dishes to the judges?
Please, may I speak first?
Of course. Do you need help?
Yes, please. I just want to share my first two bowls with my new friend, Chef Carol and Chef Jenny. At first, I only care about winning, but now I see meeting such great people is a real prize. And Taiwan is a respectable rival, not only for culinary virtuosity, but for the righteous attitude.
It's great to cooperate in depth with this friendly neighbor.
Wow, what sportsmanship! It's clear that everyone here is already a winner.
United we grow, divided we fall. Thank you.
第九队表演的题目是 The Dream is Not a Dream. 计时开始。
I can't believe you are doing this to me. I don't understand. Why are you doing this?
Mom, relax. This isn't a pet quarrel. Can't please go home first?
Okay. I grew up in a poor family in Vietnam. We didn't have much resource and we didn't receive proper education. So your dad and I worked so hard to give a better life than I had. Now you're just throwing always away.
It's not that bad, Mom. You didn't even let me finish your whole presentation. You can judge your book by its cover. I know about the life you had there. That's why I want to take a chance to explore your country. It's part of me.
It's broke? If you want to, it's broke. Why don't you go on holiday in Vietnam for a week? Why do you have to go and work there?
Mom, just 1 year contract. And if I don't like it, then I can just quit and come back.
You better speak Vietnamese.How are you going to survive there? Not to mention, you have not been that far from home. I will get worried.
Mom, but Miss Ning from the corporation said we get to attend intensive Vietnamese training lessons.
Hello, you must be Mrs. Chen. I'm the HR manager of Southern Sea. We are recruiting hardworking, passionate Taiwanese to join our company. I believe your daughter is who we are looking for.
I want my daughter to go to a graduate school, not going to a developing country and risk her life and future there.
Mom, please let Miss Lee finish. I understand your concern, Mr. Chen. Kay has already told me you are from Vietnam. It must be hard for you to imagine. The country has improved so much for the past 20 years. It has transformed from one of the poorest countries in the world into a lower middle income country.Vietnam now is the most dynamic emerging country in East Asia.
This could be a great opportunity for personal growth. I know that experience will truly widen my horizons. I understand that you want me to continue my study, but what I want is real-life education. Leave my comfort zone and change myself.
You can experience the same thing in Taiwan. Why do you have to fly all the way to another country? What about your safety?
That won't be a problem.Let's go into business orientation before departure, and the company will provide accommodation for all foreign workers.
Mom, please, this is what I want to do. There's no way you can beat the idea out of my head. It would be a great deal for me if you give me your blessing.
Okay, I don't know. Do you really think working in Vietnam is a better choice? What about your future? You will be wasting a whole year if this didn't turn out well.
Then she will get a year overseas job experience. The world is like a book. It isn't rational to just read one page and close it up.
Do you promise you will keep in touch with me every day?
Oh, Mom, thank you so, so much.
Don't worry, daughter potential. I believe she's going to be just fine.
Wow.
This is not what I want.
I should lower my expectation.
Sorry, boss. Please give me another chance. I will prove myself to you.
I hope your person will be okay. I will hate to say goodbye.
I won't let you down, boss.
Hello, my beloved workers. We gather together here today for a special reason. I'd like to give a compliment to a hardworking fella in our company. Of course, all my workers work very hard, but this particular youngest really shines through. I am pleased to announce the promotion of Keishuan to the position of a product manager. Thank you for your hard work. You totally earned it. I hope you all join me in congratulating Kay on her outstanding performance. I wish her the best luck in her future position.
Wow, this is such a big moment for me. I mean, thank you. I regretfully and humbly accept the decision by the company to offer me a promotion. I won't be here without the support of my family and the trust of the company. When I first started, it was very hard for me. The language barrier, the workload, and all the unfamiliarities. But I'm a fighter. And I think the success don't just come to you. You should be the one who go to it. I'm glad that I try my best. It makes my loved ones proud. And I promise,